When I'm not playing Animal Crossing, my favorite thing to do is hang out on the couch and watch my favorite TV shows, some of which are anime. But I'm really picky about the anime I like, so it's hard for me to find where to watch it all in one place. So that's why this video is sponsored by Crunchyroll. Crunchyroll has the world's largest collection of anime, including Naruto Shippuden, Attack on Titan, and Dragon Ball Super. And it's dedicated to offering you the best anime experience you can find outside of Japan. Crunchyroll brings over all the freshest, newest anime, and a portion of premium memberships goes back to the original creators. If you haven't already, I suggest watching The Promised Neverland. I don't want to spoil it too much, but it's about a group of orphan children who discover a deadly secret that changes everything. I may or may not have watched all 12 episodes in one sitting. You can try Crunchyroll Premium for free for 14 days. That includes ad-free HD streaming and simulcast fresh from Japan by using the link in the description or going to crunchyroll.com/illymation. Thank you, Crunchyroll. When I was in grade school, my friend Paige showed me a game called Animal Crossing. I wasn't super into it at first, but the more she let me play it, I decided I had to get this game. Now, I didn't know it at the time, but I was a furry. So my first Animal Crossing game was for the Nintendo DS Wild World. And the first time I played was on a long family road trip from North Carolina up to New York.
New York?
Wait, what? So my Animal Crossing town was named New York, all lowercase, because I was 10 and an idiot. So when I arrived in lowercase New York, I was like, well, that's the second biggest regret of my life. But then I saw him. Just for a second, you're looking at me, making me feel like maybe you want this too. Give me your attention. He called me dog. Twice.
What's all this commotion? Why is no one buying my wares? What is... Ooh.
In case you've never played Animal Crossing, whenever you start out in Wild World, you're approached by Nook, a tanuki who owns a little shop in town and basically controls the entire Animal Crossing economy, and he only wears an apron, nothing else. Ugh, you good dude?
Never better. So happy to have another malleable cog in the capitalistic machine. I mean, lovely customer, come to lowercase New York.
And then he gives you a house, but he pulls a fast one, like, oh ho ho ho, but who's gonna pay for it? You are! Then he forces you to work for him, and you have to wear this stupid uniform. Stupid leaf shirt, I'm not wearing this. Okay, I'll wear the stupid leaf shirt. Now, because I was really young, I didn't know about all the hidden secrets there were to Animal Crossing. I just liked talking to my neighbors, filling up my house with junk, and chopping down all of the trees. But then when the Wii came out, I got Animal Crossing City Folk. I don't remember what I named my town, hopefully not lowercase Minnesota or something, but what I do remember is this. Biscuit was in my town again. And just for a second. Oh, Biscuit! In City Folk, I finally understood how to play Animal Crossing. I learned how to fish, paid off my house again and again. I even donated to the museum and played online with some people. So, by the time New Leaf came out on the 3DS, I was ready. I pre-ordered it, picked up the game as soon as I could, named my town Omashu after that episode of Avatar The Last Airbender. I followed the face guide to get this one and entered my town. And you will not believe who I saw. No one's gonna believe me, but like, give me your attention. You don't know me, but I know you. In a past life, you and I are, our souls are intertwined. We are together in this wild world, among these city folk. And I promise, so long as you will have me, I will never leave you for someone new. He called me dog! Oh, ew! Ew! Because I finally knew how to play Animal Crossing, I became picky, obsessive, and honestly kind of a snob. I figured out how to passive-aggressively make all the ugly villagers leave. I managed to find a QR code of a path that looked exactly like the stones in-game and matched them up perfectly. I'd trap my villagers and then I'd run around them so they'd suggest all the public works projects. Except you, Biscuit, I love you! And how did I have time to do all this, you ask? I'd play the game until 5 in the morning, let my DS charge while I go for a jog, come back and play some more, fall asleep at 10 in the morning, wake up in time for dinner with my family, and rinse and repeat. Summer 2013, baby! Take me to the island cap and I got beetles to catch and a mansion to build! Now perhaps you've heard the saying, Rome wasn't built in a day, and there's a reason for that. See, if Rome was built in a day and built to perfection so quickly, the Romans would become bored, restless, with no goals or ambitions. So because I figuratively built my Rome in a day, I too became restless. And the only way to appease this ache was to reset. I didn't want to, I just didn't have anything else to do, you know? My house was huge, museum was filled, I had like all the items, and I had my dream villagers, shout out to Biscuit, and yet I felt empty. Yeah, I think I can do this again. Yep, I'm ready. Wait, what? Who the f*** are you? I'm Illy, this is my town, y'all think I'm the mayor, and Biscuit... Biscuit? Wait. No. Oh, no, 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 no! Biscuit! And that marks the biggest regret in my entire life. I cannot tell you how many hours I spent restarting the game in hopes of getting my precious lazy boy back in town, but to no avail. I've since committed to a restarted town, but the joy is just lost. I'm constantly chasing that feeling I had the first time I played, but also knowing I'll never have that experience again. Until now, Animal Crossing New Horizons, motherfuckers! I'm coming, Biscuit! I promise I'll never leave you again! So with that, thank you for watching my videos. Never ever delete your Animal Crossing town. And as always, stay safe. Oh, wait, what is in your mouth? Wait, spit it out! Hey, spit it out!
Why do I feel like a special announcement is about to happen? Ooh, what's this? Was I finally invited to Super Anime Sword Fighters Ultimate?
I wish something exciting happened for a change.
Oh, hi, friends.
What you got there?
Huh? A letter?
Aw, man. Are you the Angel of Death?
Yeah, dude. But I accidentally got this letter mailed to me. Wrong address. See you in 2069.
Could it be a love letter?
Oh, it's not.
Huh? Mail time.
Spit it out! Hey, spit it out! Spit it out!
Oh, it's a letter! I'm gonna be playing drawing games live with my friends!
Wow, it's even better than a copyrighted video game franchise!
It's a tour!
Well, I'm going on tour with my friends! Come and see me!
I'm going on tour with my friends!
I'm going on a multi-city drawing tour and tickets are available now?
Wow, I've never done one of these!
Wait, what's gonna happen in 2069?
And also, there's this letter. This one's from the tax man. My taxes are overdue. Oh, God.
Welcome to the end card. Here's where Illy's gonna tell you to follow her on social media and say thank you for watching. Hey, gabagool.
Thanks for having me, Illy. Bye.